leadership is defined as the ability to influence and inspire action in others, as well as respond with vision and agility during periods of growth, disruption, or uncertainty to bring about the required change, as defined by Yuan Ruke Akpabida. When social distancing measures were being brought about in 2020 during the COVID-19 pandemic, we, Team 7 of Water Environment Federation's 2021 cohort of the Water Leadership Institute, have attempted to define change leadership in the context of communication. It is the ability to introduce and embrace advancements in networking tools for communication resiliency. That is to facilitate the ability to continuously communicate effectively and collaborate within teams at an individual level, at an organizational level, or at a global level, despite external disruptions. The pandemic has brought the topic of digital networking tools to the forefront, as it acted as a catalyst to force the world to leapfrog into the communication future in a matter of a few days. The idea of digital communication was neither foreign nor radical in 2020. What was radical was the pace by which we all adapted and accepted remote work culture. Today, companies of all shapes and sizes have begun utilizing digital technologies to overcome the limitations of the physical world. Digitalization has moved into every corner of the workplace. The world is standing on the precipice of huge change, where everything, the way we work and the way we communicate, is being altered dramatically and permanently by technology. This means hosting webinars instead of seminars, organizing virtual huddles instead of face-to-face meetings, and much more. Digital transformation is not just a buzzword. Peggy Chen, the Chief Marketing Officer of SDL, says, at its heart, digital transformation is about connecting better with digital customers. To understand why, consider this. The team members of WLI have prepared this video while sitting in 6 different locations across the United States of America. And you are watching this video, perhaps next door, perhaps in the same country, or perhaps halfway across the globe. What connects us together is this digital platform and our shared interest in communication and development. Digital tools have allowed the water sector to continue to work in real time, allowing projects to progress and essential services to continue without disruption. Even before the pandemic, digital communication was relevant because it helped organizations improve everyday efficiencies, optimize operations, and achieve better employee engagement. Most organizations today make use of chat software, video conferencing, or other top communication technologies. Virtual meetings are an effective way of communicating, especially when remote teams based across regions, states, or even countries across the world need to connect at the same time without requiring travel. Virtual meetings also allow for real-time focused discussions among participants and provide opportunities for problem solving that other modes, such as a text or an email, don't. In addition, virtual meetings may be more environmentally sustainable, as they reduce greenhouse gas emissions resulting from travel and transportation, the largest greenhouse gas contributing sector in 2019, according to US EPA. As the pandemic introduced various social and economic lockdowns or restrictions and reduced transportation frequencies, research conducted by Nature shows that global carbon dioxide emissions fell by 6.4%, or 2.3 billion tons in 2020. Based on the COVID-19 pandemic, it is evident that digital tools have allowed operations within companies to continue in times of crisis. However, embracing technologies for communication is a must. The popularity of digital communication is growing rapidly, and we need to be ready to adopt new ways of communicating and collaborating within teams. It is important for us to be aware of all top trending communication technologies and be willing to utilize these digital tools. With so many options available for digital tools, the question many may ask is, which tool to use and when? We'll take a moment and look at the different factors that may influence the selection of digital tools and how to overcome some common challenges to make these tools work for you.
There are so many digital collaboration tools available that can sometimes feel overwhelming to find the best one suited for your needs. When choosing the right tool for your team and how to make those tools work for you, these are some of the most important factors to consider: the purpose of the meeting, the level of formality, project management and collaboration needs, and the culture of collaborators. So the purpose of the meeting can influence the type of technology you employ. Meetings that are meant for informational purposes, such as a progress update or kickoff meeting, may be conducted using a broadcast or webcast style platform. The presenters are able to share their presentation visuals with a large group while their screen and camera is highlighted. So the conversation is mostly one-sided with the expectation of a question and answer period at the end. The platform should allow for many participants, especially if the meeting is open to the public. For this type of meeting, a chat function is helpful so that listeners can submit questions as the presenters are speaking without distracting from the information being conveyed. The speakers can address the questions at the conclusion of the event, and if time runs out before all questions are addressed, the presenters can save the chat log and reach out to attendees afterwards. Another factor to consider is the level of formality and the extent of interaction expected during the meeting. For more formal occasions, such as a client review or formal decision-making, consider a virtual platform that provides a raise hand or ask function feature. When a participant raises their hand, the facilitators can call on the interested contributor in an organized fashion to avoid interrupting or talking over one another. A chat function is also helpful for this purpose. It helps keep a written record of any questions or points that may have been missed during the vocal discussion. A platform that allows for social events and networking requires the capability for multiple groups to be speaking and interacting at the same time. For these events, a virtual platform that allows for breakout rooms or table discussions is helpful. Facilitators can divide participants into groups, or participants can choose what room or table they attend. For smaller groups, allow for a deeper level of conversation and be less intimidating than large virtual meetings for introverted participants. For informal conversational meetings, such as technical discussions or team updates, a virtual platform where participants have the option to join via video or phone and the moderator can share their screen is helpful. The platform should allow for multiple users to interact in the discussion with minimal audio overlap. A supplemental presentation tool, such as a virtual whiteboard or notepad, is helpful to obtain feedback from participants or take active notes while the discussion is ongoing. For any type of event where an icebreaker is desired to kickstart the conversation, consider a virtual poll or survey tool. Ask the participants to complete the poll at the beginning of the meeting and view the results. Many polling tools available have the capability of displaying results in real time and can spark discussion and make attendees feel more comfortable. For quick informational collaboration, apps and programs that can be used on a smartphone are helpful. Visual project management tools can also be utilized to track tasks and team assignments, and digital collaboration tools that are useful for keeping people on task and in the loop. They can provide a central hub for communication and let you establish designated areas for different teams, tasks, or topics. This can be incredibly useful as a digital placement for the office. Features will vary depending on the tool you choose, but there are so many that are rich with features and integrations that you are bound to find one that is useful in more ways than one. When selecting digital collaboration tools, ask yourself the following questions. Does it promote easy communication between your team and external organizations? Does it keep digital materials centralized and accessible to your team? Does it allow for effective crisis communication with the best ability to reach the intended team and post any crisis messaging to them at all times? Does it meet your needs for personalizing communication? Finally, the culture and the needs of collaborators involved must be understood and considered for the selected virtual tools to be accepted. As COVID-19 cases continue to reduce and the world starts to optimistically reopen, we're seeing more flexibility in a hybrid work culture. Entities that choose to continue with full virtual work and collaboration are reminded that back-to-back virtual Zoom meetings need to be avoided for participant downtime. Zoom fatigue is a real thing. One way to allow for necessary downtime is by scheduling meeting durations for 45 or 50 minutes. A timekeeper can also be assigned to make sure scheduled meeting times are upheld. So the key takeaway from this entire section is to do your research before you jump into virtual collaboration. First, identify the communication tools your team needs. After you determine the specific needs and the team has identified a couple of options, Compare each tool by asking the questions we discussed in today's video. I would like to end with a quote from Henry Ford. Coming together is the beginning. Staying together is progress. And working together is success. So apply what you learned here today and don't let distance slow the success of your organization.
Whoa, well, that could have been an email.